Prophet is a Python time series forecast library developed by Facebook. Prophet automatically detects yearly, weekly, and daily seasonality. It can quickly decompose the trend and seasonality effects. In this tutorial, we will make a time series prediction of Bitcoin prices. The following topics will be covered: how to train a time series forecasting model using Prophet, how to make predictions and make time series decomposition, how to identify changing points in the trend, how to do time series cross-validation, how to evaluate time series model performance using Prophet. The purpose of this tutorial is machine learning education only. It is not investment advice. Therefore, please do not make an investment based on the information in this tutorial. Let's get started. In the first step, we will install and import libraries. Two Python packages need to be installed, Ifinance and Prophet. After the package installation, we need to import libraries for this tutorial. NumPy and Pandas are for data processing. Ifinance is for pulling the data. Prophet is for building the time series forecast. .plot is for model output visualization. And .diagnostics is for model performance evaluation. Plotly is imported to visualize the Bitcoin price trend. In the second step, the Bitcoin price data is downloaded from the Yahoo Finance API. We are using 2 years daily data from 2018 and 2019. Yahoo Finance downloads data with the date as an index. Using reset index, we created a new index and used the date as a column. This is because Prophet requires the date time variable to be a column for the model input. By default, the date is string type. PD.toDataTime changes it to a date time format. From the trend chart, we can see that the Bitcoin price started to decrease in January 2018 and increased since April 2019. In this tutorial, we will forecast the Bitcoin close price. Prophet takes two columns as inputs, a data time column called DS and a value column called Y. Therefore, we need to drop all the other columns, rename date to DS and close to Y. Using .info, we can see that the dataset has 730 records in two columns, DS and Y. DS is in date time format and Y is in float format. There is no missing data in the dataset. In step 3, a training and a testing dataset are created. We cannot use random split for time series data because it causes data leakage from the future dates to the past dates. Usually, a cutoff date is selected. The data before the cutoff date is the training dataset, and the data after the cutoff date is used as the testing dataset. In this example, 2019-11-30 is used as the cutoff date. The first 23 months are used for model training, and the last month is used for testing. In step 4, we will train the time series model using the training dataset. Interval width specifies the prediction interval. We change the default value of 80% to 95% prediction interval. It makes the upper bound and the lower bound of the prediction broader. And change points is the number of change points in the time series trend. The default value is 25. Based on the shape of the Bitcoin price data, I changed the default and set it at 7. The yearly seasonality and daily seasonality are automatically disabled. This is because Prophet detects that the dataset we are using does not have full multiple years of data and does not have units smaller than a day. Step 5 uses the trained Prophet model to make the prediction. We use the last 31 days to create the future data frame. This is the same as using the testing dataset we created above. The prediction output contains lots of information. We kept the predicted value it had, and its prediction interval upper and lower bound value. The x-axis is the date in the forecast visualization, and the y-axis is the Bitcoin close price. The black dots are the actual prices in the training dataset, and the red dots are the actual forecast prices. The blue line is the time series model prediction. The shaded area is the 95% prediction interval. If you find the contents helpful so far, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. In step 6, we will decompose the time series forecast. From the trend chart, we can see a decreasing trend from early 2018 to early 2019. an increasing trend from April 2019 to July 2019, and a decreasing trend after July 2019. The weekly seasonality chart shows that the Bitcoin prices decreased starting Monday and reached the lowest on Thursday. Then the prices started to increase and get the highest on Saturday. In Step 7, we will discuss how to identify the change points in the time series trend. Profit automatically identifies the change points in time series data following the steps below. 1. Specify the percentage of data used for identifying change points. The default is 80%. 2. Identify a large number of uniformly distributed dates with possible trajectories change. 3. Apply a sparse prior on the magnitudes of the change rate, which is similar to L1 regularization. We can list the dates corresponding to the change points using dot change points. In the visualization, the red dotted lines represent the change points. It does not include all the 7 change points in the chart. Only the ones with more changes are included. In Step 8, we will do cross-validation for the time series model. Profit has a cross-validation function to automate the comparison between the actual and the predicted values. M is the trained model. Initial equals 500 days means the initial model will be trained on the first 500 days of data. Period equals 60 days means 60 days will be added to the training dataset for each additional model. Horizon equals 30 days means that the model forecasts the next 30 days. When only horizon is given, profit defaults initial to be triple the horizon, and period to be half of the horizon. Parallel equals processes enables parallel processing for cross-validation. When the parallel cross-validation can be done on a single machine, processes provide the highest performance. For larger problems, Dask can be used to do cross-validation on multiple machines. There are 730 days in the dataset. Therefore, after setting the 500 days for the initial model training and 60 days period, there are enough data to train 3 models and forecast the next 30 days. Step 9 evaluates the cross-validation model performance. MSE sums up the squared difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. RMSE takes the square root of MSE. ME sums up the absolute difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. MAP sums up the absolute percentage difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. MAPE is independent of the magnitude of data, so it can be used to compare different forecasts. But it's undefined when the actual value is zero. MDAP is similar to MAPE. The difference is that it calculates the median instead of taking the average of the absolute percentage difference. SMAPE is similar to MAPE. The difference is that when calculating absolute percentage error, the denominator is the actual value for MAPE and the average of the actual and predicted value for SMAPE. Plot cross-validation metric method from Profit helps us to plot the cross-validation performance results. The x-axis is the horizon. Because we set the horizon to be 30 days, the x-axis has a value up to 30. The y-axis is the metric we are interested in. We use MAP as an example in this visualization. On each day, we can see 3 dots. This is because there are 3 models in the cross-validation, and each dot represents the MAPE from one model. The line is the aggregated performance across all the models. We can see that MAPE value increases with days, which is expected because time series tend to make better predictions for the near future than the far future. In this tutorial, we talked about how to make time series predictions of Bitcoin prices. The following topics are covered: how to train a time series forecasting model using Profit, how to make predictions and make time series decomposition, how to identify changing points in the trend, how to do time series cross-validation, how to evaluate time series model performance using Profit. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and natural language processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.